everybody, I'm Sean. Welcome to our bilingual storytime channel. Do you ever worry what people think of you? I don't. So today, we are going to read A Bad Case of Stripes.
大家好，欢迎来到双语绘本。你有没有担心别人对你的看法呢？今天我们就来读一本书，书的名字叫《糟糕，身上长条纹了》。Let's start it.
A Bad Case of Stripes by David Shannon.
糟糕，身上长条纹了。作者大卫·香农。
Camilla Cream loved lima beans.
卡米拉·特里姆很喜欢青豆。
But she never ate them.
可是她从来不吃青豆。
All of her friends hated lima beans.
她所有的朋友都讨厌青豆。
And she wanted to fit in.
她也想和大家一样。
Camilla was always worried about what other people thought of her.
卡米拉总是很担心大家怎么看她。
Today, she was fretting even more than usual.
今天她比平常更焦虑。
It was the first day of school.
是开学的第一天。
And she couldn't decide what to wear.
她不能决定自己该穿什么衣服上学。
There were so many people to impress.
她得让更多的人对她印象深刻。
She tried on 42 outfits.
她试了42套衣服。
But none seemed quite right.
可是没有一套衣服看起来对劲。
She put on a pretty red dress and looked in the mirror.
她穿上了一件红色的漂亮洋装，看了看镜中的自己。
Then she screamed.
然后她突然尖叫起来。
Her mother ran into the room.
她的妈妈冲进房间。
And she screamed too.
也尖叫了起来。
Oh my heavens!
Oh, 我的天哪！
She cried.
她吼道。
You're completely covered with stripes!
你全身都是条纹。
This was certainly true.
他说的没错。
Camilla was striped from head to toe.
卡米拉从头到脚都是条纹。
She looked like a rainbow.
她看起来像彩虹。
Mrs. Cream felt Camilla's forehead.
克里姆太太摸了一下卡米拉的额头。
Do you feel all right?
你还好吗？
She asked.
她问道。
I feel fine.
我很好呀。
Camilla answered.
卡米拉回答。
But just look at me.
看看我变成什么样子了。
You get back in bed this instant.
你现在赶快上床休息。
Her mother ordered.
她的妈妈告诉她。
You're not going to school today.
今天别去学校了。
Camilla was relieved.
卡米拉松了一口气。
She didn't want to miss the first day of school.
她不想错过开学的第一天。
But she was afraid of what the other kids would say.
可是她很担心别的小孩怎么说她。
And she had no idea what to wear with those crazy stripes.
她也不知道身上这种疯狂的条纹要搭配什么样的衣服才好。
That afternoon, Dr. Bumble came to examine Camilla.
那天下午，结巴医生来给卡米拉做检查。
Most extraordinary, he exclaimed.
真的很奇怪，他大声地宣布。
I've never seen anything like it.
我从来没见过任何人得这样的病。
Are you having any coughing, sneezing, runny nose, itches, pains, chills, hot flashes, dizziness, drowsiness, shortness of breath, or uncontrollable twitching?
你有没有咳嗽、打喷嚏、流鼻涕、酸痛、疼痛、发冷、发热、头晕、嗜睡、喘不过气来，还或是无法控制的抽搐症状呢？
No, Camilla told him.
没有，卡米拉告诉他。
I feel fine.
我觉得很好。
Well then, Dr. Bumble said, turning to Mrs. Cream.
那好吧，
结巴医生说。他转向克里姆太太。
I don't see any reason why she shouldn't go to school tomorrow.
我找不出任何理由让她明天不上学。
Here's some appointment that should help clear up those stripes in a few days.
这里有一些药膏，应该可以帮助她在几天内消除这些条纹。
If it doesn't, you know where to reach me.
如果涂上药膏还是没有救的话，你知道在哪里能找到我？
And off he went.
然后他就离开了。
The next day was a disaster.
第二天的情况简直是场大灾难。
Everyone at school laughed at Camilla.
学校里的每一个人都嘲笑卡米拉。
They called her Camilla Crayon in Night of the Lily Living Lollipop.
他们叫她卡米拉塔蜡笔，还有棒棒糖狂欢夜。
She tried her best to act as if everything were normal.
她尽可能的表现的一切正常。
But when the class said the Pledge of Allegiance, her stars turned red, white, and blue. And she broke out in stars.
当全班同学一起宣誓时，她身上的条纹竟变成了红色、白色和蓝色的，而且还冒出了好多星星。
The other kids thought this was great.
其他的小孩觉得卡米拉身上发生的事情棒极了。
One yelled out, "Let's see some purple polka dots!"
一个小孩大喊，秀一些紫色的圆点。
Sure enough, Camilla turned all a pattern of squares covered her skin.
给我们看吧，不必想也知道，卡米拉的全身布满上布满了紫色的圆点。
Someone else shouted, "Checkerboard!"
另一个人大叫，棋盘方格图案。
And a pattern of squares covered her skin.
她的皮肤上就盖满了方格花纹。
Soon, everyone was calling out.Different shapes and colors.
没过多久，每个人就叫出不同形状和颜色。
And poor Camilla was changing faster than you can change channels on a TV.
可怜的卡米拉身上的图案变换的速度比遥控器替换还要快。
That night, Mr. Harms, the school principal, called.
那天晚上，学校的校长哈姆斯先生打电话到家里。
I'm sorry, Mrs. Cream, he said.
很抱歉，克里姆太太。
I'm going to have to ask you to keep Camilla home from school.
她说，我要请你让卡米拉待在家。
See, she's just too much of a distraction, and I've been getting calls from the other parents.
别暂时别来上学，她让其他同学很分心。我也一直接到其他家长打来的电话。
They're afraid those stripes may be contagious.
他们很担心那些条纹会传染。
Camilla was so embarrassed.
卡米拉觉得很不好意思。
She couldn't believe that 2 days ago, everyone liked her.
她简直不敢相信，两天前每个人都很喜欢她。
Now, nobody wanted to be in the same room with her.
现在却没有一个人愿意跟她待在一个房间。
Her father.Try to make her feel better.
他的爸爸试着安慰他。
Is there anything I can get for you, sweetheart? He asked.
宝贝，我可以帮你准备些你需要的东西吗？他问道。
No, thank you.
不用了，谢谢你。
Sighed Camilla.
卡米拉叹气道。
What she really wanted was a nice plate of lima beans. But she had been laughed at enough for one day.
其实她真正想要的是一盘好吃的青豆。可是她今天已经被嘲笑得够多了。
Well, yes, I see. Dr. Bumble mumbled when Mrs. Cream phoned the next day.
好的，是的，我知道了。当克里姆太太第二天打过电话去时
I think I'd better bring the specialist. We'll be right over.
结巴医生喃喃自语地说
我想最好带几位专科医生到你们家。我们马上就到。
About an hour later,
大约一个小时后
Dr. Bumble arrived with 4 people in long white coats.
结巴医生和四个穿着白大褂的人一起抵达。
He introduced them to the creams.
他向克里姆一家人介绍他们。
This is Dr. Grop, Dr. Sponge, Dr. Cricket, and Dr. Young.
这几位是格罗医生、卡尤医生、蟋蟀医生、杨格医生。
Then the specialists went to work on Camilla.
接着，这些专科医生就开始给卡米拉的身上工作了。
They squeezed and jabbed and tapped and tested.
卡米拉被他们又捏又戳又拍又打又测试的实在很不舒服。
It was very uncomfortable. Well, it's not the mumps.
不是腮腺炎。
Concluded Dr. Grop.
格罗医生下了结论。
Or the measles, said Dr. Sponge.
也不是麻疹，卡尤医生说。
Definitely not chicken pox, put in Dr. Cricket.
绝对不是水痘，蟋蟀医生补充道。
Or sunburn, said Dr. Young. Try these.
也不是晒伤，杨医生说，试试这些吧。
Said the specialists. They each handed her a bottle filled with different colored pills.
专科医生们说，他们每一个人都交给他一罐不同颜色的药丸。
Take one each before bed, said Dr. Grop.
上床睡觉前，每种药丸吃一粒，格罗医生说。
Then they filled out the front door, followed by Dr. Bumble.
接着，他们就依次走出前门，结巴医生走在最后。
That night, Camilla took her medicine.
那天晚上，卡米拉吃了药。
It was awful.
结果糟透了。
When she woke up the next morning, she did feel different.
第二天早上起来，她的确感觉不太一样。
But when she got dressed, her clothes didn't fit right.
可是当她穿好衣服时，却觉得衣服不合身。
She looked in the mirror.
她照了照镜子。
And there, staring back at her,was a giant multicolored pill with her face on it.
结果在镜子里看到的是一颗印着她的脸的巨无霸胶囊。
Dr. Bumble rushed over as soon as Mrs. Cream called. But this time, instead of the specialists, he brought the experts.
克里姆太太一打电话，结果医生马上就赶到，可是这一次他带来的不是专科医生，而是专家。
Dr. Ward and Mr. Mellon were the finest scientist minds in the land.
葫芦博士和西瓜先生拥有全国最科学的聪明头脑。
Once again, Camilla was poked and prodded, looked at and listened to.
跟上回一样。卡米拉被又戳又刺，又看又听。
The experts wrote down a lot of numbers.
专家们记录下许多数据。
Then they huddled together and whispered.
然后就靠在一起窃窃私语。
Dr. Gord finally spoke.
葫芦博士终于开口了。
It might be a virus, he announced with authority.
可能是由病毒引起的，他很权威地宣布。
Suddenly, fuzzy little virus balls appeared all over Camilla.
突然，毛茸茸的小病球就出现在卡米拉的全身。
Or possibly a form of bacteria.
或者是某种形态的细菌。
Said Dr. Mr. Mellon.
西瓜先生说。
Out popped squiggly little bacteria tails.
卡米拉全身又跳出了弯弯曲曲的细菌小尾巴。
Or it could be a fungus.
也可能是一种真菌。
Added Dr. Gord.
葫芦博士补充。
Instantly, Camilla was covered with different colored fungus blotches.
卡米拉身上立刻盖满了不同颜色的真菌斑块。
The experts looked at Camilla.
专家们看看卡米拉。
Then at each other.
然后又看看对方。
We need to go over these numbers again back at the lab.
我们需要回到实验室检查这些数据。
Dr. Ward explained.
葫芦博士解释道。
We'll call you when we know something.
我们一有结果就会给你打电话。
But the experts didn't have a clue.
可是专家们并没有找到任何线索
，much less a cure，
更别说解药了。
By now, the TV news had found out about Camilla.
这时候，电视新闻媒体已经找到了卡米拉。
Reporters from every channel were outside her house.
每个频道的记者都聚集在她家门外。
Telling the story of the bizarre case of the incredible changing kid.
报道不可思议的变色龙小孩的奇怪案例。
Soon, a huge crowd was camped out on the front lawn.
一大群人很快在他家前院的草坪扎营。
The creams were swamped with all kinds of Randia. The creams were swamped with all kinds of remedies, from psychologists, allergists, herbalists, nutritionists, psychologists, an old medicine man, a guru, and even a veterinarian.
克里姆家用尽各式各样的疗法，从心理学家、过敏学家、草药学家、营养学家、精神学家，到一位年老的老巫，一位智者，甚至还有一位兽医。
Each so-called cure only added to poor Camilla's strange appearance until it was hard to even recognize her.
每一种所谓的疗法只是让可怜的可米拉的外形变得更奇怪。
She sprouted roots and berries and crystals and a feather and a long furry tail.
最后你根本认不出他了，他的身上发芽，长出浆果、水晶和羽毛，还有长出一条毛茸茸的尾巴。
But nothing worked.
可是没有一种方法有效。
One day, a woman who called herself an environmental therapist claimed she could cure Camilla.
有一天，一位自称环境治疗学家的女人声称她可以把卡米拉治好。
Close your eyes.
闭上你的双眼。
She said.
她说。
Breathe deeply and become one with your room.
深呼吸，然后与你的房间合二为一。
I wish you hadn't said that.
我真希望你没说出刚才那句话。
Camilla groaned.
卡米拉抱怨道。
Slowly, she started to melt into the walls of her room.
她开始慢慢融进房间的墙壁里。
Her bed became her mouth, her nose was a dresser, and two paintings was her eyes.
床变成了她的嘴巴，鼻子是一个橱柜。两幅画就是他的眼睛。
The therapist screamed and ran from the house.
这位治疗学家尖声叫着跑离了他们家。
What are we going to do?
我们该怎么办？
cried Mrs. Cream.
克里姆太太哭着说。
It just keeps getting worse and worse.
情况变得。越来越糟。
She began to sob.
她开始抽抽搭搭的小声哭泣。
At that moment, Mrs. Cream heard a quiet little knock at the front door.
就在这个时候，克里姆先生听见前门传来很小的敲门声。
He opened it.
他打开门。
And there stood an old woman who was as plump and sweet as a strawberry.
门外站着一位像草莓一样又胖又甜美的老婆婆。
Excuse me, she said brightly.
我打扰你们，真是不好意思。她很愉快地说。
But I think I can help.
不过，我想。我能帮得上忙。
She went into Camilla's room and looked around.
她走进卡米拉的房间，到处看看。
My goodness! She said with a shake of her head.
我的天哪！她摇摇头说道。
What we have here is a bad case of stripes.One of the worst I've ever seen.
你得的是很严重的条纹病，是我见过所有病例中最严重的。
She pulled a container of small green beans from her bag.
他从袋子里拿出一个装着小青豆的罐子。
Here, she said. These might do the trick.
在这里，他说，这些可能有效。
Are those magic beans? Asked Mrs. Cream.
这些是魔豆吗？克里姆太太问。
Oh my no! Replied the kind old woman.
Oh, 我的天，当然不是。
There's no such thing.
慈祥的老婆婆回答，没有那样的东西。
These are just plain old lima beans.
这些只是青豆。
I'll bet you'd like some, wouldn't you? She asked Camilla.
我知道你想吃一些，对吧？他问卡米拉。
Camilla wanted a big, heaping plate full of lima beans. More than just about anything, but she was still afraid to admit it.
比起任何东西，卡米拉真的很想吃一大盘堆的满满的青豆，可是他还是不承认。
Yuck! She said, no one likes lima beans, especially me.
好恶心啊，他说，没有人喜欢吃青豆，尤其是我。
Oh dear, the old woman said sadly, I guess I was wrong about you.
哦，亲爱的，老婆婆伤心地说，我看错你了。她把罐子放回包包，朝大门走去。
But you, she put the beads back in her bag and started toward the door. Camilla watched the old woman walk away. Those beans would taste so good.
卡米拉看着婆婆走开，那些青豆一定很好吃。
And being laughed at for eating them was nothing compared to what she's been going through. She finally couldn't stand it.
和她这段时间的经历相比，为了吃青豆被笑实在没什么。她终于忍不住了。
Wait! She cried.
等一下！她大喊。
The truth is, I really love lima beans.
说实话，我真的很喜欢青豆。
I thought so, the woman said with a smile.
我想也是，老婆婆微笑着说。
She took a handful of beans and popped them into Camilla's mouth.
她拿出一把青豆，把它们扔进卡米拉的嘴里。
said Camilla.
卡米拉说。
Suddenly, the branches, feathers, and squiggly tails began to disappear.
突然，那些树枝、羽毛，还有弯弯曲曲的尾巴开始消失了。
Then, the whole room swirled around.
接着，整个房间开始转了起来。
When it stopped, there stood Camilla.
当房间停止转动时，卡米拉就站在中间。
Everything was back to normal.
所有的事情都恢复了正常。
I'm cured! She shouted.
我得救了！她大喊。
Yes! Said the old woman.
是呀，老婆婆说。
Yet I knew the real you was in there somewhere.
我知道，真实的你就在里面的某个地方。
She patted Camilla on the head.
她拍了拍卡米拉的头。
Then she went outside and vanished into the crowd.
然后她就走向屋外，消失在人群中。
Afterward, Camilla wasn't quite the same.
后来卡米拉变得不太一样。
Some of the kids at school said she was weird.
学校里有些小孩说她很怪。
But she didn't care a bit.
可是她一点也不在意。
She ate all the lima beans she wanted.
她尽情享用她爱吃的青豆。
And she never had even a touch of stripes again.
而且身上再也没有出现过一点条纹。
Keywords.
关键词
Stripes.
条纹
Doctor.
医生
School.
学校
Kids.
小孩
Medicine.
药
The end.
完。
你喜欢这个故事吗？我喜欢。我们下次见。Do you like this story? I do. See you next time. Bye!
Bye. 再见。